be one.
I'll be one.
You're just in time for the christening.
Yeah.
I'm calling it Tahitian Madness.
It's playing. What do you do? Eat it? Light it? Throw it or drink it?
It looks magnificent.
Oh, thank you, man. The exotic drinks are a specialty of the Balamiki Baker. Now, this one has 4 kinds of rum, 5 fruit flavors, and a dash of milk.
Oh, why the milk?
It's a health food trade.
Gloria Dannora.
Yeah. Yeah, and this is Adam Troy.
That's Clay Baker.
It's a pleasure, man. Well, drinks are on the house, folks. But remember, they're like fortune cookies. There's a message in each one.
Thank you, Mr. Baker.
It's a pleasure, man. Go ahead and try it. How is it?
I got the message. Tell me, what do you do, Adam?
I own a schooner, take passengers and cargo around the islands here.
From where?
From here, Tahiti.
Oh, well, you must know the island pretty well, then.
I'm learning.
Well, I'd like to. That's why I hired the car. I don't want the tourist treatment. I'd rather get out and see for myself.
It's a step in the right direction. How long are you going to be here?
About 3 days. Any idea where I should start looking?
Well, you'll need a good guide.
Where I should start looking?
Well, I'm only free for 2 days.
I'll look fast.
I'm hired.
Good.
Hmm.
sir. Oh, say, we got a brand new drink. Tahitian Madness.
Scotch and water, please.
Any idea what you'd like to do first?
Well, I'd like to see the island, get to know the people. Maybe take part in a little emotion that I know is here. Does that sound corny?
Oh, no, not if you mean it.
I do. You know, I've wondered, do you really have the things that I've read about here, like the mountain pools and the ivory-colored beaches and diamond crystal waters?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we have all those things.
Oh, well, let's go see them now.
What about the Tahitian Madness?
Strictly tourists.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tahiti.
Captain, you've got a huge curiosity, Bob.
Don't I, though? All I know about you is your name. That you're a bad driver, good swimmer.
Yeah.
That you're beautiful.
Drove past. You said you wanted me to see it by night.
Hey,
talk?
Oh, yes. I'm just an old-fashioned girl who's about to do an old-fashioned thing.
Which is what?
Take you to meet Mom and Dad.
Waverly.
How do you do, Miss Waverly?
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Thank you.
And Dr. Finney?
Finney?
Tony Mace?
Hi. Mr. Mace?
Mr. Pelote? And Captain Ford.
How do you do, Captain Fuller?
Pleasure to meet you.
You like a drink, Captain?
A gin and lime, please.
Mother, we had such a lovely time. I'll never forget Tahiti. Oh. Oh. Dear, could we go ashore? I want to see something of Tahiti. It's hard to be so close and not see it after reading about it all your life.
You'll see it, Francis.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Away. I'd like you to be our guest, Captain.
Wait a minute, Mr. Dannora. I can't be your guest. I've got to be ashore. I'm to be your guest whether I want to be or not.
That's right. You see, Captain, I need you.
What for?
To save my life.
Is under lock and key. Captain Quillen and his men are all in my employ. Tony Mace, Mr. Pelote are both armed.
May I ask why? Why this ship? Why this doctor? Why this nurse?
My name, my full name, is Michael Dannora. Does that mean anything to you?
Oh, yeah. You're a gangster.
That's a newspaper expression. Nevertheless, and for a variety of reasons, I find it impossible to set my foot on land in any country in the world. There are extradition papers waiting for me in every port. I'm a wanted man. If there's anything that I need, there's no place I can go to get it.
I do hope you will enjoy your sail, Captain. It will be delightful to have someone new aboard.
Francis, dear, it's getting late. Why don't you go to bed?
Oh, dear. Yes, I am a little tired.
Good night. Are you ready?
Ready for what?
Just a routine physical examination, Mr. Troy. Tony, get him a clean shirt.
Things must be real tough in the medical world, Doctor.
For your information, came aboard this yacht much the same way you did, in Panama.
Shang, how are you two today?
I've worked for Mr. Dannora for 6 years.
Perfect health.
How about the blood type? Does it match?
Yes.
Seems almost too good to be true.
You and Captain Troy are quite rare. Only 4% of the population. Did you know that you were AVRH negative, Captain?
Yes, I heard that once. Look, what's all this about anyway?
Show him, Doctor, the latest X-ray.
Take a look, Captain. Light spot. Just there. It's shrapnel.
I was standing next to a man when he was killed by a bomb.
As you can see, the shrapnel is now in a critical position. This is the heart.
We have to operate aboard ship.
We're going to anchor on the lee side of Pelote Island in the morning. It's as calm as a lake there.
It's going to be a very difficult piece of surgery, Mr. Dannora. A one man and a nurse.
Well, that's all we have, Doctor. Captain, now I guess you know why you're here.
Oh, yeah, things are getting clear. You want a transfusion from me, don't you?
That's right.
One question. How much of a transfusion?
We shouldn't need too much, Captain. Miss Waverly has known for some time that this operation would have to take place one day. She prepared for it. Plasma, glucose solution, saline solution. All we need. We'll immediately restore the bulk loss of whatever blood we take from you with that. No danger. The transfusion is the same as those performed every day in 1,000 different hospitals.
It's too bad you don't have as much confidence in my chances, Doctor.
Plasma, saline, and glucose will keep you alive too, Mr. Dannora.
If the operation is a success.
Well, I guess it about wraps it up. Can I go now?
Sure, Captain. You can have complete run of the ship. Of course. Keep an eye on you.
Of course.
It'll be all right,
to do, let him die.
What was I supposed to do, care?
He's my father.
That's your tough luck.
Who you can see is a gangster.
Is there anything else to him?
Yes, he's a loving father and a devoted husband.
Why don't you tell that to his victims? Tell that to the junkies and the prostitutes and the guys.
That was all years ago. That's behind him now. Anyway, who knows if that's all true?
Police department in the world.
Why do you think your father can't set foot on land anywhere?
He's given me love and devotion.
And money and toys and cars.
But I did, I do again.
Sure, because you're his daughter. What do my feelings matter to you?
Your feelings have nothing to do with this. You're here to give him a simple transfusion. Now you'll be back in Papiti in a few days and everything will be fine.
Oh, sure, and we can pick up our little love affair again.
All right, Troy. Dr. Finney says you're supposed to get a lot of rest.
Good old Dr. Finney.
Get him out of here, Tony!
be alone?
No.
Captain Troy's a nice young man.
He's all right.
Regret what you did?
No.
You like him, don't you?
Like him? Well, he's no different from the doctor or the nurse. You need him.
Good night.
Good night.
Don't worry, everything's just where you left him.
Who told you this was my cabin?
Little Bird. It's in a bad spot, though. I'm pretty near the engines. You know, if I was charging fares for this, I couldn't get much. Strictly fourth class, you know what I mean?
Why don't you keep quiet?
Hey, Mr. Pelote, how does it feel to spend your life in orbit around my Dannora? I mean, how long has it been since you've been able to come and go of your own free will?
Big mouth.
You think Mr. Dannora will ever let you go back to Chicago? Back to Maria? So what was it she said? Dannora will never let you go, Jill. He's only got you, Quillen, and Mace. And he needs all of you. You'll never get back to me and the kids, not until Mike Dannora's dead. Isn't that what you said? Huh?
You read these?
Yeah. You know, Maria's right. Dannora is on the run. His only salvation is to keep the high seas. You'll never get to home court, not unless Mike Dannora's dead.
Who is it?
It's me, Lisa Waverly.
Just a minute.
Think it over, Joe. Remember, we're in the same boat.
You to have a sedative.
I tell him no thanks. You call one of those gunmen in here, you're gonna see a real Donnybrook. I sleep better now.
Wouldn't have hurt you. Just don't cut up tonight or I'll get in trouble.
I'll be a good boy. Been a nurse long?
You're rather ingenious, Captain. What did you have in mind? For me to help you get out of here?
It flashed through my mind. But really, I was wondering what someone like you is doing sailing around the Pacific with a retired crook.
And what should I be doing?
In some clean, modern hospital. After all, you are a nurse.
Clean, modern hospitals are not what they're cracked up to be.
Been bringing up some doctor's children.
Let's just say I'm not the type.
Let's just say I don't believe you.
Well, I take back what I said about you being ingenuous.
When a pretty and intelligent woman chooses a lonely life, you know, there must be a reason somewhere.
All right. The truth is that a doctor's wife should be like Caesar's wife. Above reproach. I was Michael, Dannora's private nurse, subpoenaed by the prosecution for two of his trials. By the time the tabloids got through with me, it's that simple.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Well, there's nothing to worry about. Of course, I can't go home, but there must be a spot someplace. Some little backwater place where a woman... Adam. What's it like living in Tahiti?
Tahiti's nice. Nice people. You work. Sit on the beach, read a book, swim, work again. Worry about the mortgage on your schooner.
Adam, I have $38,000 in a bank in Switzerland. Mr. Dannora pays me well. I have no expenses. It's just sitting there waiting.
Yeah, waiting for what?
Well, you know, for Mr. Wright to come along. Adam, $38,000 is a lot of money. You could own the Tiki free and clear. We could go any place in the world. We could have a I'm not even good enough for the captain of a schooner in the South Pacific, am I?
Please, I didn't say that. I
forget it.
Lisa?
After I've stripped my soul bare, are you kidding?
He's driving out of that room.
No, why?
Dannora wants to see everybody in the dispensary. Come on.
What's happened?
The plasma. Somebody smashed all the bottles. Come on.
Transfusion?
It's impossible. Without that plasma, the transfusion might kill him.
Why?
Shock! And a dozen reasons you wouldn't understand.
We can't operate.
We can and we will. Plasma as much as Troy. You'll die if I operate.
I'll die if you don't.
Daddy, do what Dr. Finney says. Radio for a plane and go to a regular hospital.
What then? Spend the rest of my life in prison?
Better than the grave.
I give you my word. If I operate without that plasma, you'll die. Killing Troy won't net you a thing.
Talk, Michael. Dying, killing people. It isn't right, Michael. Do you think it's right, Gloria? Daddy, listen to me. I love you and I want you to live, but you can't live without help. A hospital. Surgeons. Everything you need.
Send a message to Suva. Ask them for a plane. Make all the arrangements at the hospital and take Dr. Finney along. He'll know what to say.
Thank you, Daddy.
Mr. Dannora, before you send that message, I think there's something you ought to know. There's plasma, glucose, and saline aboard.
Are you sure?
When the medical supplies first came aboard, there wasn't room enough to store everything in the dispensary. So I stored some of it in my room.
Plasma? Plasma, is that the stuff we need? All right, doctor, let's get moving.
How much is there, nurse?
500 cc's of plasma and 1,000 cc of saline and glucose.
Then the situation's the same. There's not nearly enough for both you and Captain Troy.
I'm not interested, but what about me? Is there enough for me?
I'm a doctor. I'll try and save your life, but I won't murder another man to do it.
All right.
You gave me the answer. We operate.
And it's going to be a successful operation, Dr. Finney. An almost certain death for him.
No, Daddy, don't. Don't.
Enough talking.
Come on, get him gone. Try back to your cabin.
You're overlooking one thing, Dannora. You're not going to live very long, no matter how the operation comes out.
And you can send me flowers.
Why do you think those bottles were smashed? Because somebody here wants to keep you alive? Just a question of the next opportunity, Dannora. The next opportunity.
All right, get him out of here.
Joe, take him back to his cabin.
Revenge, huh?
No, self-preservation.
Better come on in, Joe. We got things to talk about.
We got nothing to talk about.
You're in a spot, Joe. What do you think Dannora's gonna do when he finds out you smashed his bottles? Mace is gonna figure out sooner or later where everybody was.
What are you trying to pull? I was right outside this door.
Sure you were. With every chance in the world to slip into the dispensary when the nurse is in here with me.
You're crazy.
Am I? Has Dannora ever seen those letters from Maria, too? Where'd you stash those?
By the time they find your body, Maria's letters will be at the bottom of the ocean.
What are you gonna tell Dannora? You killed me while I was escaping? Huh? Me, the one who means life or death to him?
It's the only chance I had. Nora had to die. Maria's last letter. A woman can't wait forever, can she?
She doesn't have to, Joe, if you help me.
Help you how?
Get me to the radio room.
Pelote, Maria!
A pleasure cruise. A real pleasure cruise.
Why don't you go up on deck and get some fresh air?
Yes, I think I shall. The sea air is so stimulating. Don't you think?
That's right. Of course. Good night, Mrs. Dannora.
I knew it was you, Pelote. Kids, Mace. My kids! He was the only one I never really trusted. That's why I had him take you to your cabin just now. How'd you know he was the one? How'd you pressure him?
That's a secret.
From a deep emotional trauma.
I speak English.
Might call it a nervous breakdown.
I always thought he was such a nice man, Michael.
You just rest, Francis.
everything's going to be all right.
She doesn't hear you.
Will she recover?
I can't make any promises, Mr. Dannora. I'm a surgeon, not a psychiatrist. She's had a deep shock.
You do your best. Don't worry, honey. She'll get over it.
I hope she never does. And she'll never see what's going on around her.
You'd better go to bed now, Mr. Dannora. You'll need all the rest you can get.
That he won't, too. I wish I never brought him here. He promised nothing would go wrong. Oh, what good are your promises? You're Michael Dannora.
Yes, and you're Michael Denora's daughter. But you want to forget that now that the going is rough. It never bothered you when you were riding the gravy train, when things were smooth, when you were getting everything that you wanted.
I never asked.
The most expensive. Nothing was too good for you. Then you were ready and willing to close your eyes to everything and say, Daddy, I love you.
I still do. It's just that...
It's just that you want things to come easy. You know, I never gave you one thing. It's strange because it's the most valuable thing I have to give. I never made you strong and tough and ready to stand up and fight. Well, I'm still strong. I'm still tough. And I'm ready to fight for my life. I'm sorry you're not on my side.
Anything like this would happen. Your life would be in danger. And I hope with all my heart that nothing goes wrong.
Mr. Mace, I'd like to be alone.
All right, we better go.
No. No, I can't leave you like this. Listen, I just talked to Dr. Finney, and he said you have a good chance. He meant it. He wouldn't have said it unless he meant it.
Doctor, with a gun at his head, he'll say a lot of things.
All right, we better go.
Get out.
Come on. Come on. Where's the nurse? Mr. Dannora. All right, you better go look after your mother.
It's only water.
Listen,
why should I lie?
It's only
give me her arm.
Don't make trouble, Troy. You got a good chance.
I didn't know whether to believe you or not.
I didn't know whether it would work or not.
What happened to my father?
I'll radio for Tahiti. A plane as fast as possible. Let's go. Come on.
Does he have a chance?
More than here, my dear.
Polynesian rainmaker.
Oh. What does it do?
It's for people who are afraid of droughts. Two of these and you swear it's raining.
Adam?
Hi. How's your phone?
Coming, Mom. I think he'll make it. Thanks for giving him the transfusion. And thanks for making the report to the police.
Yeah, well, of course they said there wouldn't be any charges against you.
Mother and I are leaving now.
Well,
doctors say that she'll be fine with love and care.
Good.
I'd like to come back here.
Let me know if you do.
there's a lot of Tahiti I haven't seen yet.
Goodbye.
Yeah. Say goodbye.